Good evening, everybody. Thank you for attending the recital this evening. For those of you who I have not met and been able to introduce myself to, my name is Jeff Webb. I am the Associate Professor of Music and Director of Choral Activities here, as well as being the Music Department Chair here at UPJ. We are very excited to present, certainly for the first time in my 20 years at UPJ, and I believe for the first time in the history of UPJ, an actual senior voice recital. We have two students who have been studying voice for several years now. They have performed together in many different facets in the concert choir and the Johnstown Symphony Chorus. They did a performance of The Telephone, which we'll talk about later on today. And now they're going to present for you, their family and friends, a senior voice recital. And so let me introduce to you Madison Eppley and Ryan Fry.
Oh,
Figaro was one of Mozart's most successful operas. The plot follows a day in the life of Count Almaviva, who has taken an interest in Susanna, who is engaged to Figaro. Cherubino, the Count's page, has become enamored with Countess Almaviva. When the Count learns of Cherubino's affection for his wife, he sends Cherubino away. Then the Countess, Figaro, and Susanna concoct a plan to expose the Count's own infidelity and humiliate him, which leads to a night in the garden full of humorous mistaken identities and culminates in the Count's humiliation and the Countess's forgiveness. Susanna pretends to sing this aria directly to her beloved, the Count, while Figaro is in earshot. Figaro falls for the ruse, as was Susanna's intent all along, and declares his love for her.
Oh,
Songs of Travel is a song cycle that was originally written for baritone and piano by British composer Ralph Vaughan Williams. In all, 9 songs make up the complete cycle in which we hear the tales of a weary world traveler. The Vagabond is the first song in the cycle and introduces us to this resolute traveler proceeding through the rough terrain in the English countryside. Educator is you should be well-rounded. So far in the program, we've heard a lot of what many would consider to be more classically oriented pieces, but it's also important for them as singers to be able to sing repertoire from other genres. And so the next 3 pieces that Madison and Ryan are going to sing are what you would consider to be quote-unquote non-classical type of pieces. Madison is going to start by singing the song Still Hurting from the 2001 Broadway musical The Last 5 Years. Ryan is then going to sing a simple song which comes from the piece Mass, or the larger scale work Mass, which was written by Leonard Bernstein. Most of you know Leonard Bernstein from West Side Story and Candide. And then finally we're going to have Madison singing from the Broadway musical Phantom the song Hope. Sorry, I've skipped the song. So all of that stuff that I told you about, non-classical stuff, just save it for after this classical piece that Madison's getting ready to sing. All right, the cool level. All right? I was so excited about the Broadway stuff. So. The Dodger is a 19th century folk tune and campaign song that was arranged as part of a collection of old American songs by Aaron Copland in 1950. The song is linked to the 1884 presidential election of Grover Cleveland and was apparently used to belittle his opponent, James Blaine. Fantastique that was composed by Jacques Offenbach. It was Offenbach's final work and was premiered in February of 1881, 4 months after his death. The opera is set in three acts, each of which depicts a tale in which the main character, a poet named Hoffman, reveals stories about the three great loves of his life. Act one is about Olympia, who is an automated doll. The evil scientist who has created the doll has tricked Hoffman by selling him a special pair of glasses that make him think the doll is a real person. In this aria, commonly referred to as the doll song, Olympia sings of the birds in the arbor and her love for them. Thinking that his affections are being returned to him by Olympia, Hoffman begins to dance with her only to fall and break his glasses and see that he has fallen in love with an automated doll.
Thank you.
Mozart's opera Don Giovanni, in which the nobleman Don Giovanni, played by Riot over here, has been seducing women all over Europe, and now his eyes are on the peasant named Zerlina, played by Madison, who is engaged to be married to Mazzetto. Little by little, Don Giovanni pleads with Zerlina, promising her all the pleasures in life if she comes to his little villa. Zerlina attempts to resist, but in the end, she succumbs to his charms and agrees to andiam, andiam, and run away with Don Giovanni.
Thank you. Thank you.